Hello everyone and welcome to Getting Started with Strapi. In this video, I will show you how to build your content architecture without writing a single line of code. To do that, we will use the Content Types Builder. Once the content architecture is built, Strapi will generate the ready-made REST or GraphQL API that can be connected to any frontend. It saves developers a lot of time since they usually would have to write the API by themselves from scratch. Using a content types builder also reduces the risk of errors and abstracts away the complexity of managing or customizing the API endpoints at scale. In this series of videos, we will be managing content on a demo website called Food Advisor. It has a homepage, it has a restaurants page with different places and categories, a pricing page, a blog page, and an FAQ page. Let's see how the content type builder works. With this tool, we can add and delete content types and also change their fields. A content type is a category of content you will have in a project. You can use single types for one-of-a-kind pages or elements, for example, a homepage or an About Us page or a footer. These elements usually have a unique content structure. That's why it's best to have them as single types. You can use collection types for content that has many entries like articles, categories, or restaurants. Many CMSs do not differentiate between single and collection types. Still, this differentiation is very handy to create a structured content architecture. It allows you to easily find one-of-a-kind pages, making content editing more efficient and organized. Each content type consists of fields, the building blocks to which you can afterwards add content. You can add new fields at any time by clicking on this button. You can choose amongst the 12 standard fields such as text, rich text, number, date, boolean, etc. And you can also, starting from Strapi v4.4, add custom fields. For example, in this project, we have the Sticky editor installed to replace the standard Strapi text editor. You can add different custom fields like Shopify, color picker, map, etc. This feature provides a lot of flexibility to adapt your requirements and makes Strapi very customizable, extendable, and future-proof. Custom fields save a lot of time for users who want to integrate Strapi with other tools and manage the third-party data more effectively within Strapi. The standard options will not limit users, and if their needs evolve, Strapi evolves with them. Let's go back to the default fields and pay more attention to the relation type of field. This type of fields allow you to establish a relation with another content type. For example, we can add a relation between a restaurant and a category, which will then allow us to assign a category to a restaurant. Same with a place or reviews. The API response displays this relationship, making it easy for you to query all restaurants that have a specific category or a place or a review. There are different types of relations: one-to-one, one-to-many, and many-to-many. Choosing the right relation type improves the database performance and the user experience. In this example, we choose the many-to-one relation type because a category may have multiple restaurants, but a restaurant may only have one category. But we can change that if, for example, we want to allow a restaurant to have multiple categories. Let's say a restaurant can be French, European, and Mediterranean at the same time. We can change these relation types to many-to-many, which means a category may have many restaurants and a restaurant may have many categories. So this is up to you how to set this relation up. Let's see how the relations work in practice. To do that, let's go to Content Manager. This is where we add final content. And let's open the Restaurant tab. We can choose a random restaurant and see where we can see the information category. So in here, we can choose amongst different categories, but we can only have one at the end. So in this case, it's Lebanese. And we can also navigate to the category page and see the list of different restaurants that belong to this category. Now, let's say that we see a typo and we want to fix it. We are currently at the category page, but if we want to update the name of the restaurant, We can do that very easily. And once we save that, whenever we go back to the category page, Lebanese, we can see that this content has been updated everywhere, both in here and on the restaurant page. So you don't need to go on each page and fix the typo everywhere. Since these content types are connected, it's automatically updated. Having different relation types allows creating a more sophisticated content architecture and having the right content displayed on each content type. It allows you to make the content as reusable as possible and makes navigation easier for the end users while improving the search engine optimization. Thank you for watching this video. In the next tutorial, I will show you how to add and manage content in Strapi. Don't miss it!